Hey, so we're back on our lattice now that we finished the scene, and we're going to do a little movie breakdown of Anne Frank. So we're going to do this on our lattice. We're still going to get more information about dramatic irony and take a few more notes that we add on to this lattice, and then we'll finish the rest up for homework. So let's take a look. Oh, there we are. Okay. You might have to turn this down. Whoever's working the computer might have to turn it down. We're going to find out together. Ooh, there go a bird. There's another bird. I wonder if that'll come back. There goes another bird. That sound that we hear, that's the west. The video. I'm gonna pause the video. There we are. So let's take 10 seconds back. Let's get another 10 seconds back. There we are. So if you haven't gotten this yet, this is the Westertoren. Westertoren. I might be misspelling this. We're gonna be all right. So if you can make sure that's on your lattice, please. Okay? And I'd also like you to add this. This will be an offstage sound. Or a sound effect. All right, because remember, even though this is a movie, we're still going to be watching it on stage, right? There's a stage right there, and here's some curtains on either side. All right, and there's the room that we're about to see. Let's see, does this just let me erase this quickly? No, I gotta do it the old-fashioned way. Oh my gosh. Well, let's keep watching while I erase. Let's keep watching while I erase. Well, that looks like there's a truck and there's a bunch of people in the back. I wonder what their situation is. We're seeing everything through barbed wire here. We see the rumor of war and the sonorous clang of that bell. If you ever heard the boy in the striped pajamas, those are the exact type of striped pajamas they're talking about. Those are what they forced Jews to wear in the concentration camps there. That's most of it. It's Amsterdam, so there's the canals there. We, the audience, are kind of spying on Mr. Frank from above. So remember, this is all about the audience. There's Mr. Frank. Very slow, deliberate pacing in this beautiful black and white. There's Meep, Mr. Crawler. Now he's not included in the play. They include him in the movie. Right, and here's the annex. Notice the overturned chairs over here. The blackout curtains so that planes couldn't see them at night. Look, this has been damaged here, right? It looks dumpy. It looks dumpy, and it's meant to look. It's meant to make you think, oh my gosh, what happened here? There's the many colored scarf mentioned in the stage directions. If we didn't get stage directions on our lattice, now's a great time to do so. Hey, Mr. Crawler. Hey, Meep. And then that's where the stage directions kind of leave off on page 102 that we were reading, where he sort of breaks down. He loses his composure and his self-control, for which he's famous. He's very gentle and cultured. There's the Westertoren. Crawler.
Mr. Crawler. My good friends. Oh, it is so good to see you home. We had heard nothing. I'm alone.
You must come home with us. Rest now. You must stay with us.
No, I can't stay in Amsterdam.
Mr. Frank, this is your home. Amsterdam is your home.
It has too many memories for me. Everywhere there's something, me. Everywhere. Me. Even seeing you and Mr. Crawler. Forgive me, I shouldn't talk to you like this after all that you did.
I would do it again. Everything except some papers.
You saved your letters and papers.
So Mr. Frank says to burn the papers, right? So we watched this part already. So too many what? Too many what? He says there's too much what in Amsterdam. And the function of this, of this thing, which for which the diary reminds him, is what we're trying, he's trying to shake, and what we're trying to think about.
Anna's diary is where she left it.
While she finds this diary, right? This is where we left off. Right on page 103 and 104. Right? The suffering. Burn them, he says. Burn this. She hands it to him. Hands what to him? Cue the music. There it is.
9th of July, 1942. 1942 is impossible. Only 3 years ago. Dear diary, since you and I are going to be great friends, I would start by telling you all about myself. My name is Anna Frank. I am 13 years old.
Here comes that switch over, see? Coming over soon. You can hear it now.
Things went well for us until the war came.
German occupation. Then things got very bad for the Jews. You could not do this, you could not do that. We had to wear yellow stars. I had to turn in my bike. I couldn't go to a Dutch school anymore. I couldn't go to the movies or ride in an automobile or even on a streetcar. And a million other things. But somehow we children still managed to have fun. This morning, Father woke me at 5 o'clock and told me.
So now we're going back in time.
We were going into hiding. I was to put on as many clothes as I could. It would look too suspicious if we walked along carrying suitcases. We were going to disappear.
We're now in memory.
Thin air.
There's Anne Frank.
I'm living a great adventure. Three other people were coming in with us. Father knew them, but we had never met them.